President Trump signs a bipartisan budget. The more than $1.3 trillion deal features more spending for the military and increases the national debt. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell calls the plan a win for pro-lifers. A report in The Hill says McConnell praised Democrats for not trying to add pro-abortion measures to the budget. The proposal also left in place the Hyde Amendment, which bans federal funding of abortion. Rachel Bovard, Senior Director of Policy at the Conservative Partnership Institute, joins me now. Rachel, thanks for being on the program.
Thanks for having me.
So let's talk about this. Mitch McConnell says it's a major win for pro-lifers. Fiscal conservatives like yourself say not so fast. And you have officially said it represents the funeral of fiscal conservatism. What makes you think there's no turning back?
Well, this deal ultimately undoes the gains of the 2011 Budget Control Act, which is the biggest win for fiscal conservatives in decades. This new bipartisan budget deal totally eviscerates those gains. So Congress is able to spend without limit for the next 2 years.
And I want to ask you, as President Trump said, he would eliminate the national debt. Mm-hmm. What do you make of that?
Well, I think the White House went into these negotiations knowing they wouldn't get everything they wanted because obviously Democrats are in charge of the House. But I think they were hoping Senate Republicans would have their back a little bit more than they did in these budget negotiations. The White House proposed $150 billion in savings that the Congress could take. Senate Republicans only took $70 billion of those, and they are not likely to take effect at all. So
before the vote, President Trump tweeted, two-year deal gets us past the election. Go for it, Republicans. There's always plenty of time to cut. On that, how likely do you think cuts are going forward?
Well, Congress hates nothing more than a spending cut, so I don't think it's incredibly likely. I hope that there's some Senate Republicans who show some fiscal restraint in the upcoming appropriations process, but if history tells us anything, kind of unlikely.
Let's talk about now the pro-life side of this. It contains several pro-life measures, a commitment of the Trump administration. How do you think this deal works to help the president's reelection strategy?
You know, I think he's able to tout that he's working with Congress. You know, he hasn't really combated them on this issue. But I think from the pro-life perspective, it's important to make some distinctions here. This is a budget deal. It is not a spending deal. And so all we have right now between House Democrats and Senate Republicans and the president is a handshake agreement that they won't go after pro-life priorities in the future. We still have to do appropriations. Those are the spending bills. So that's going to be where the rubber meets the road in seeing if the Democrats are willing to keep their commitment.
Let's change gears here a little bit. The president says Texas Representative John Ratcliffe no longer is a candidate for the Director of National Intelligence. What do you think happened here? Why did he drop out, and what's going to happen going forward?
Yeah, John Ratcliffe, a very highly qualified member of Congress, was nominated for the DNI position, withdrew after facing very, very stiff opposition from Senate Democrats who, you know, as of late now go after President Trump's nominees on a personal level. He didn't want to put his family through that. And increasingly, this is what we're seeing from Senate Democrats. They've taken the gloves off, and this confirmation fight, like any confirmation fight, would be too grueling, I think, for someone with young children.
And let me get you on this. We saw two nights of Democratic debate. What was your takeaway from the two nights? And who was the winner?
Well, I think Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders controlled the first debate. They refused the bait to turn on each other. And so I think you really saw their very far left borderline socialist ideas come out in the first debate. The second night, not clear on who the winner was. I think Tulsi Gabbard had a very good standout performance. But my big takeaway is just how left, how far to the left this party has swung from even where they were 5 or 10 years ago. The second night, they spent more time bashing Barack Obama as too much of a moderate than they did anyone else.
Okay, Rachel Bovard, Senior Director of Policy at the Conservative Partnership Institute. Thank you for being here with us.
My pleasure.